macOS is full of super useful features like AirDrop, Mission Control, and Quick Look, but there are a lot of super underrated ones as well, like Universal Clipboard and Hot Corners, and some more that I bet you didn't even know existed. So as a veteran Mac user of 8 years, today I'll be explaining and then ranking all of these features in a tier list. Remember that this is just my personal opinion, and be sure to stick around until the end because I have some hot takes you might want to hear. I'm going to start with features that you can access on the desktop. First up is Quick Look. Quick Look allows you to press space to quickly preview files without opening any apps. You can even press arrow keys to quickly switch to the surrounding files. This saves me so much time when I'm looking for documents, images, or audio files, especially when making videos. This gets an S tier. Next up is Stage Manager. Now, Stage Manager is marketed as a great productivity feature that organizes your app windows into stacks on the left-hand side of your screen, so you can easily switch through them as you need. I really want to give this an F tier because I personally hate this feature. I can't even full screen with it and I do not like the window previews, but I've seen some people use it, and so I'll be nice and give it a B tier. Besides, there's a better alternative for organizing windows, and it's Mission Control. Mission Control gives you a bird's eye view of all the windows you have open, so you can easily switch between them. I've set a keyboard shortcut for it and it is so much faster than using Stage Manager because I can organize my windows super easily. This is definitely an S tier. Next up is Split View. If you didn't know, you can snap windows side by side to make your work easier. For example, you can watch some Subway Surfers content while working on your history essay. Now, I don't really use this feature often, but it's still useful in some cases, so I'll give it a B tier. Then we have Quick Note. Quick Note just opens a new notes window so you can quickly write something down. The default keyboard shortcut to open it is really weird though, and I don't use the notes app anyway. So this would get an F tier if not for the next feature, Hot Corners. You see, Hot Corners allows you to assign certain actions when you put your cursor in a corner. So for example, if I set Quick Note to the bottom right corner, I can quickly make a new note, which bumps up the Quick Notes to a B tier because it is way more convenient than pressing the weird keyboard shortcut. But of course, there are other actions you can do, like opening the Mission Control and revealing the desktop, which are both really useful. So I'll give this an A tier. Widgets also gets an A tier. They're like little info panels that go on your desktop, showing quick data from apps like Calendar, Reminders, and even other apps that support widgets. I really like this widget, for example, which gives me motivational quotes every day, but I could live without it. Then we have Stacks. Basically, it collects the different file types together, organizing the files for you. I don't like it though, because it groups all screenshots together, for example, even if they're for two completely different topics. I'm sorry, but I gotta put this in F tier. Next up are Apple ecosystem features. These are features that are specific to Apple devices and make you love the Apple ecosystem. And Universal Clipboard is a great example. Basically, if you copy something to your clipboard on your Mac, you can paste that same thing on your iPhone. Great feature, but I personally don't use it as often, but still A tier. Next up is Handoff. Basically, if you're using an app on your phone, a little icon will appear on your Mac or iPad, and you can continue from that device. Now, I personally don't see how this would be useful, because let's just say I'm searching something up on my phone. Why didn't I just search it up on my Mac in the first place? B tier. And of course, we cannot talk about Apple's ecosystem without talking about AirDrop. If you somehow don't know what AirDrop is, it's this Apple feature which allows you to quickly share files between Apple devices wirelessly. S tier, don't need to explain more. So quick interruption, I forgot to put iPhone mirroring here as a feature, but it gets an A tier. Now it is a really cool feature, but controlling my phone with a trackpad is just really weird and impractical. Continuity is the last one for this section, which allows you to use your iPhone as a webcam in video calls or to scan documents. Definitely super useful, but I don't use it too often, so I'll give it an A tier. Next section is navigation and search, and we're starting off with Spotlight. Off the bat, I'm putting it in the B tier, and let me explain why. Spotlight is a core feature of macOS, serving as a system-wide search tool for files opened by pressing Command and Space, but you can also perform web searches, calculations, and find definitions. It's definitely essential for macOS, so it should be an S tier, right? Well, not exactly. You see, I've been using Raycast for the past year, which is like an upgraded version of the Spotlight tool. Some main improvements include clipboard history and the community-made extensions. Go watch the video I made on it for more info. Launchpad is another search tool, this time for apps. It shows you all the icons of the apps, so you can find them easily, kind of like on iOS and iPad. Personally, I remember the names of the apps I need, and I use Spotlight Search for them, so I rarely use Launchpad. B tier. Finder tags allow you to color code your files with different colors and tags. Honestly, I think folders are a much better way of organizing your files, and I've never even seen anyone use this. F tier. If you want to automate organizing your files, you can also use Smart Folders, which automatically organizes your files depending on certain criteria that you set. So for example, I can get it to group all the files that start with A. I personally find manually sorting files to be better, so this gets a B tier. Next up are miscellaneous features. Text replacement lets you type a short shortcut and have it automatically turn into a long phrase. I've made multiple for weird characters and some for my email addresses. It might just be me that uses it this often, but I'm giving it an S tier. Focus mode is a feature that works across all Apple devices and it serves to block notifications so you can concentrate on your work. You can of course edit the mode so you can still receive important notifications from certain people as well. This is a must for school so I don't get distracted during class, and it is an S tier. Night shift automatically shifts the color of your screen to be warmer at night, which decreases the blue light and is nicer on the eyes. This is an S tier because my eyes would hurt so bad in the dark without this. And to finish off the tier list, we've got the Shortcuts app. Yes, I am aware it is an app, but it still counts as a useful macOS feature. Shortcut allows you to automate tasks on your Mac. So for example, I have this shortcut for when I do work. I just type work into Raycast and it turns on Do Not Disturb, starts a timer, and also changes my screen to black and white. This is really useful, but I don't use it every day, so it's an A tier. If you enjoyed this tier list and you want to know more about macOS features, then go check out this video next.